Good morning, and congratulations to CSA School, class of 110. Designed to instill the skills and qualities deserving of this certificate. You've been through a demanding course, which required a great deal of mental and physical stamina, personal pride, and extraordinary team effort. Throughout the course, you have all been exposed to a rigorous training schedule, which has prepared you for your duty in one of the most demanding and rewarding career fields in today's military. Team Chief Matthews will present the graduation certificates. Attention to award. From United States Navy, Naval Technical Training Center, Detachment 4, Greg Adams. This certifies that you are a culinary special graduate and you have met all the requirements to graduate from CSA School. Conferred at CSA School, NTTC, Detachment 4, Greg Adams, Virginia, this 10th day of May in the year of 2024. Signed, A.J. Johnson, Chief Warrant Officer 3, Officer in Charge. For March. CSSR Abrams, USS Nimitz. CSSR Chera, USS Stair. CSSN Afifi, USS Harry S. Truman. CSSR Aldaco, USS Sullivan. CSSR Alexander, USS Lincoln Island. CSSN Aquino, USS Abraham Lincoln. CSSA Burton, Groton, Connecticut. CSSA Brody, USS America. CSSR Camacho, USS Germantown. CSSR Clergé, USS Comstock. CSSM Collins, USS Boston. CSSN Coronado, USS Curtis Wilbur. CSSA Rivera, MMCV1. CSSN Dickey, USS Carl Vinson. CSSA Fontenesse Laredo, USS Carl Vinson. CSSN Goldsmith, USS Wayne E. Meyer. CSSR Goddard, USS Musty. CSSR Gurley, USS Pearl Harbor. CSSR Hart, USS Iwo Jima. CSSR Putin, USS Iwo Jima. CSSR Ishmael, USS Sampson. CSSN Jackson, USS America. CSSN James, USS Michael Moore. CSSR Kabir, USS Green Bay. CSSN Propelka, USS Tripoli. CSSR Lassane, USS Carl Vinson. CSSR O'Bain, USS Comstock. CSSR Perales Jimenez, USS Sterrett. CSSR Perry, USS Iwo Jima. CSSR Richardson, USS James E. Williams. CSSN Salazar, USS Fitzgerald. CSSN Seamachin, Groton, Connecticut, Submarine School. CSSN Thomas, USS Harry S. Truman. CSSR Turner, USS. Course, our Navy students challenge themselves and their peers to grow more personally and professionally. We will now recognize the individual achievements of those students who excel in both performance and academics. Sanction Matthews will present the awards. The following awards is given to the class leader, assistant class leader, master at arms, and duty section leaders. The students receiving these awards have shown great poise, innovation, and dedication to duty, reflecting great credit upon themselves. Front and center, CSSN Jackson, CSSN O'Bain, CSSN Coronado, CSSN Camacho, and CSSN Goldsmith. Attention to award from Officer in Charge, Naval Technical Training Center, Detachment Fort Gregg Adams, subject letter of appreciation. I want to personally thank you for your superior performance while volunteering to be a student leader for CSA School Class 110. Your acceptance of the position displays true leadership, professionalism, and motivation. Your performance was exemplary, and you have set an exceptionally high standard of excellence for your future class leaders to emulate. Your actions have reflected great credit upon this command and yourself. Congratulations on a job well done. Signed, A.J. Johnson, Chief Warrant Officer 3, Supply Corps, United States Navy. So for this leadership, I think the class remembers on day one, a lot of them wanted to run for leadership, and I said, nope, we're not doing it. Right? Because that's not what you're here to be. Because at the end of the day, everybody can be a leader. It's just the ability that you have to instill within yourself to do the right thing and having that great integrity. Just because you wear that rope doesn't make you better than the next person beside you. It's just saying that you're going to take charge and hold the next person accountable to being the leader as well as you. So I told everybody in this class they're leaders. But the group you see before you, right, even though I denied them, they kept pushing and they kept bugging, right? So I had no choice but to notify them and let them lead by example, right? I want you all to take this to the fleet with you because the integrity that you have, the integrity that you set before you, right, it's going to come with a lot of challenges, it's going to come with a lot of obstacles. But always remain humble. Have great integrity upon yourself and be yourself no matter what. And I wish you success in the future. Students, right, please. Hold on. The next award I'd like to present is for the Superior Culinarian Award. My definition of a superior culinarian is not just one that can cook great biscuits or have the fluffiest omelet. It's just somebody that exerts excellence throughout, you know, whether that's through success or whether that's through failure, because I'm a firm believer of you never learn in life unless you learn from your mistakes and move forward to do better. So these individuals have shown me that since day one. I like to call front and center CSSN Burton, CSSN Brody, CSSN Collins, and CSSN Turner. So to stand on the stage, I want y'all to know that the sky's the limit. And the great tenacity that you all showed me over these last couple of weeks, I have no doubt that you will be far more successful in the fleet as long as you keep applying yourself, applying yourself, applying yourself. Stay a sponge, soak up all the knowledge, and your future is bright. Thank you. Students, right, face it. The next award I would like to present is the Hard Charger Award. A hard charger in my eyes is just someone that never gives up, someone that never quits, someone that keeps the same energy, momentum, day in, day out, whether it's adversity, whether it's success, no matter what is bestowed upon that person, they find a way to achieve and they find a way to strive. And this sailor that I gave this award to is well deserving of that, because this sailor knew they bugged me every day, day in, day out, from the time I got here, out of my car, to the time they left and went back to the barracks. So I commend you, and I want you to keep going and doing great things. Without further ado, front and center, CSSN issue. So Mr. Ishley, right, we had some good times. But when I tell you, this young man will be standing in my cart or just to give me a handshake and ask me how my day was going. As soon as he got here, he never stopped. Every day was the same energy. Every single day. And we had some times on Ishley. Don't leave me yet. I gotta talk a little bit about you. Right? We had some times, right? You got some good talking to sometimes, and you know, sometimes you got some great words of appraisal, but I will say, man, I commend you and respect your hats off to you because you never gave up. Whether it was me coming down hard on you or me lifting you up after, you know, whether it was a test or something you didn't quite get right or understood it, you're still 10 toes down, man. And I can respect, you know, a sailor every day, sun up and sun down. And it lets me rest easy knowing that you're going to go to fight for what you believe in and what's right. And you keep that same attitude and good energy. So good on you, Success Edition. I appreciate you. Student, right? First, fall out. Next, I would like to present my honor graduate. This award is presented to the student who has achieved the highest grade point average. So the sailor that I'm getting ready to call up, out of the 5 tests, I think this sailor may have missed 2 questions throughout all 5 tests. Very, very bright sailor, as all of you are. No shade. But this young person has a brain like no other. Sometimes I didn't even understand how this sailor interpreted the information in the way this sailor brought things to me, made me a different understanding. So I do appreciate you, and I just want to tell you congratulations. Without further ado, front and center, CSSN Salazar. So, CSSN Salazar, right, you definitely have me on my toes every single day. Because I've been teaching this for a good little minute, and you even opened my eyes to different ways of teaching. So I really appreciate you for giving me some different skills. This just goes to show that the future is evolving, right? We have to all be willing to adapt to that future and make changes to make this job as easy as possible. So I thank you, CSSN Salazar. Good job. Student, right place. And lastly, I would like to present my accelerated petty officers. This award is given to those who perform with exemplary work professionally and personally during their 5-week course. They will assume the rank of petty officer third class within 4 to 10 months upon arrival of their new command. Front and center, CSSN Camacho, CSSN Goldsmith, CSSN Diggy,
let's go, Diggy.
CSSN Capella.
I'm talking about
so these 4 sailors before you, sometime in the next 4 to 10 months, will be getting propped to E4, which is third class petty officer, so CS3s. That does hold a lot of weight in the fleet, for they're probably going to go jump right into being watch captains and in their leadership position immediately. But over these last 5 weeks, they have shown great integrity, great leadership skills, helping the class out, whether it was studying, tell them to lock it up in rings, get it stepped, you name it. It's put together in unison. And I have no doubt that they're going to be great third-class playoffs, and they're going to bring their peers along with them and keep impact on the fleet. So really, really good job on the four of you, and I appreciate everything y'all taught me over the last 5 weeks. Students, right face. We will now have closing remarks by our officer in charge, CWO 3 Johnson.
All right, morning, motivators.
Morning, sir.
I don't think y'all ready to graduate. Let's try that again. Morning, motivators.
Morning, sir.
That's what I'm talking about. Seats. How y'all doing this morning?
Good, sir.
Okay, I see. Y'all ready to graduate?
Yes, sir.
Some of you have been here since what, December? Or
January, sir.
Huh?
January.
You know, some have been here since December. But, November? Okay. It's time to leave. Go do great things. So, I was just sitting over there thinking, like, what tools can I give you for your tool bag? What can I tell you to let you know that everything is going to be okay when you make it out to the field? So, I got a question for you. How many people here has had a bad day before in their life? Everybody has experienced a bad day before. Now, if I ask you a question, what is your experience for meeting bad days? Some of you may say, hey, sir, it's 50%. Some of you may say 60%. Some of you may even go as high as 90%. But I'm here to say this. Your experience for meeting bad days is 100%. 100%. Let's think about this. Every bad day you have had in your entire life, you have made it past it. Think about that. Every bad day you have had in your entire life, you have made it past it. So, the saying that, you know, the clouds will go away and the sunshine will come through, I think that's a true statement. Not saying that you won't face obstacles. You won't face hurdles. You won't have some hard and some trying times when you make it out to sea. But guess what? I believe, I know that you will make it through. You will make it through. Your good days will outweigh your bad days. Now I ask you, how does it feel to graduate?
Yeah. Great.
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 Like you just accomplished something great, right? You have accomplished a great milestone into your military career. A great milestone in your military career. Just begin. So when I'm looking at you, I see my next CS1, CS2s, my next leadership, my next chiefs. I see my reliefs. You are the future of the fleet. You are the future of the fleet. So most people ask me, hey sir, what does it take to be successful in the military? I say you do three things. You show up and work on time, have a square away uniform, do what your leadership tells you to do, you'll be better than 50% of the people in the fleet. Just that easy. Show up and work on time. Have a square away uniform, do what your leadership tells you to do, you'll be better than 50% of the people in the fleet. Now, you say, sir, you know what I'm saying, I need a little bit more extra push. I need something else. I strongly recommend you get a mentor. Get a mentor who's in the position where you want to be in life. Where you want to be in life? Where you want to be in your military career? You can have more than one. I don't want to say, hey, yes, sir, my mentor is my homegirl. Was, roommates back in boot camp, or, you know, that was my bunkmate. No, get you someone who's where you want to be at in your military career. Hypothetically, if I tell my father I want to be a CWO5, or I want to be the highest ranking military official that he knows, right? My dad can't help me out with that. He can't help me out. They'll say, go ahead, son. You got it. But guess what? He can't give me the tools I need to be successful and the goals that I have. So get you the right mentor for the job. And if you find somebody in the position where you want to be at, ask them, hey, what does it take to be where you at? And hopefully, you have a great mentor that can show you that path, and you will travel that path with the least resistance. No hurdles. No obstacles. It'll be easier for you. want y'all to tell me a question. I mean, answer this question. What do y'all believe y'all have superpowers? You're like, I don't know, sir. Right? I'm going to show you guys that you guys got superpowers. Show you guys superpowers, and I'm going to show you that you are the heartbeat of the ship and the morale of the fleet. You are the heartbeat of the ship and the morale of the fleet. Now, I'm going to ask you this simple question. What meal are you looking forward to eating once you leave here? And who's going to cook it? Just let me know. What meal are you looking forward to eating? And who's going to cook it? Somebody let me know.
Boy, it's all macaroni and cheese and broccoli.
Okay, who's going to cook that? Yep. Who's going to cook it?
Your mom.
Your mom. What you got?
Some crawfish.
Some crawfish. That's what I'm talking about. Somebody else.
Some steak, mashed potatoes, macaroni, baked beans, shepherd's pie, and my mama gonna make it.
Your mama gonna make it. Woo! That's your baby, right?
That's my baby. I'm gonna cook it. I am.
Somebody else. What you got? What y'all plan on eating? Mr. Beefman, what you got?
I'm not sure yet. I'm so hungry. I'm not even in the mood to eat.
Okay, okay. Somebody else. What you got? What you eat? I'm waiting. I got time. What you got?
I'm gonna go straight to the ship.
But you gonna eat something along the way?
Some tamales.
Some tamales. That's what I'm talking about. What you got, ma'am? What you planning on eating? Yeah, something you forward to eating. Some Haitian food. Okay, how do you know I ain't kosher? How do you know I'm not kosher? Then I don't know what Haitian food is. Okay. This is just saying. We're gonna be like, yeah, we know what that is. Yeah, right there. Yeah, you got that. All right, so anyway, you see the smile on everybody's faces right now? Just us thinking about food, and it has made us feel a little bit better. You know what I'm saying? Just us thinking about food and how good food is, it has brought a smile to everyone's face in this room. Guess what? You guys control food. You guys control what people eat. You guys can control somebody's mood just by the food that you cook. So every time you produce a product, I want you to produce it with the intent of changing their mood, changing their day. Changing their mood, changing their day. Now, think about this. When those times you had those bad times, those hard trying times, and you sat down and you ate some good food, if it was that Haitian dish, if it was that steak and mashed potatoes that your mama gonna make, right? If it was that pork chop that your mama gonna make, got it. Did you think about those bad times during that time you were eating? During that period, when you was eating that good food, every problem that you had for that moment just went away. Now, if the food was trash, guess what? You're like, man, the food's bad. Now I gotta deal with this and I gotta deal with that. But if that food is good, guess what? Man, Chief, you know, me some more. I can go another 5 weeks to CSA school. No? All right. Yeah. Anyway, but you guys control food. You guys control morale. So every time you produce a product, I want you to produce it with the intent of changing their mood, changing their day. Right? I like to say a little analogy. Anybody know the significance of a tree? A tree. Everybody see trees everywhere, right? Now, one thing that you don't know, or you probably just haven't realized about trees, is that a tree grows the same way below ground as it does above ground. Same exact design, right? If you look underground, look at the root system, it looks that way, but it's underground before it starts sprouting up, right? Now, guess what? A tree is strong, tall, all this other stuff. But a tree had to, just think about the ground. What is the ground? The dirt. It's hard, right? It's a lot of obstacles that you're going to have to push through, right? The roots have to push through, the dirt, make its way, push through the ground, and to make a tree as strong as it is. So I'm saying this to you, is that what's done in the dark, eventually, it's going to come up to the light. The hard work that you put in the dark, eventually everybody else is going to see you. You don't need everybody to start patting you on your back. Oh, good job, good job. Guess what? You're not putting in the work. If you want to stand out, you want to go above everybody else, you got to put in the work when nobody sees you. when nobody sees you. You're going to have to stay during your off time. You're going to have to work on your qualms. You're going to have to put in the extra time, the extra hours that it takes to develop yourself, mentally, spiritually, and physically. You're going to have to do it. And you don't need a pat on the back. Eventually, everybody is going to see the greatness that you are. So don't be afraid to put in that work for yourself so you can grow. Everybody else is going to see your greatness. All right. So when I say it's too easy, you guys say it's too easy. When I say we got this, you say we got this. And when I say all in, you guys say all the time. It's too easy.
It's too easy.
We got this.
We got this.
It's too easy.
It's too easy.
We got this.
We got this.
All in.
All the time.
All in.
All the time.
Thank you. victory.